lilac-breasted roller that we were watching a little bit earlier, and this bird is taking advantage of this elephant being so close. What it's hoping is that the elephant chases up a tasty grasshopper, which it will then snatch up as it flies out of the grass. Of course, these birds would battle to actually catch the grasshopper once it's gone into the grass. And so being so close to this elephant works in this bird's favor, although I think that was a little bit too close for comfort. Oh, this is a beautiful female elephant. The pattern on her head there that David's zooming into there now for you is just dried mud. It's not her skin. However, that secretion from behind her eye is from her skin. That's a sebaceous gland. And it's just weeping a little bit. And as it dried up in the sun, it's left that white residue there. And the reason for that is a little bit of stress. It could also be an indication of a hormonal change that she's going through at the moment. And it just causes that gland to leak. It's nothing to worry yourselves about or anything like that. This elephant's still 100% perfectly normal. That woolly-necked stork in the background. Nice, we can while our way with the elephant while we're waiting for lion to mate. Now, while we're waiting for those lion to mate with each other again, OD Farming has asked what the social structure or family structure of elephants are. OD Farmer, let's see this little baby. I think he's going to chase this stork. OD Farmer, that's actually quite a nice question, because very similar to hyena, elephant societies are matriarchal. In other words, the herd that we're with at the moment will be head up by a cow, a female elephant, not a bull elephant. Bull elephants born into a herd will, between 12 and about 18 years of age, separate themselves for longer and longer periods from their family, to a point where they're actually not associated with their natal herd anymore. Will wander around until they are about 35, and then at 35 years of age, they will go into a period where their bodies actually change, and they go into a state called must, where they actively search out females that are ovulating, and will combat with other males for the right to ovulating females. Let's go backwards a little bit, just so that, for one, I can get out of the smell that we are sitting in at the moment. It is coating the back of my throat like you have no idea. Whew. Sorry, Dave. Wowza. Now, Philip, you want to know if the calves can be aged. I'm just going to finish my question with OD Farmer quickly. Females... And I'll get to that, because Philip, your question does make sense in context to OD Farmer's question about the dynamics of a family group. Now, although males will then at 35 plus fight for females and be associated to females and all that, the females will stay in a herd their entire life. So they'll be born in a herd and will basically live in a herd their entire lives. When a herd gets bigger than 12 to 16 individuals, it can split off, where two sisters will split off with their calves, and you can get two satellite herds forming that can actually join up again in drier times around common food sources. And congregations of 100 plus elephant are quite common in areas where food sources can draw elephant in from, you know, hundreds of miles all around them. And these particular elephant will all be related to one another. And now for Philip's question. Philip, you wanted to know if elephants can be aged. They absolutely can. You've got to take them in relation to their moms. So a small calf with a small mom will be smaller than a large calf with a large mom. And although that sounds pretty reasonable, logical, it can actually complicate things. Another thing is to have a look at the teeth. So this youngster here, you'll see, has some teeth erupting out of the jaw, just started to erupt out of the jaw. And when they do that, when you can see that, that elephant is just over a year old. The elephant on the right-hand side, the youngster on the right-hand side, same profile, only you can't see any teeth coming out there. And that elephant is less than a year. So elephant get a, they get milk tusks, and at about 6 months you can sometimes see those little milk tusks, sharp, frail little tusks. They will fall out at about 6 months, and then the more robust tusks erupt at about a year. So that gives you an idea of elephant up to about a year. From a year to 5 years, all elephants look pretty small, and then they start to get bigger than their moms. I'm talking about unable to fit under their mom's tummies is actually what I wanted to say. From about 3 years to about 7 years, and then from 7 years on, for male elephant and female elephant, their size changes dramatically. And from about 9 years to 12 years, female elephant just smaller than their moms, male elephants are just bigger than their moms, and of course onward from there, as they get to adolescence and then eventually into adulthood around their late teens, early 20s. Now,